Merry Christmas, everyone. I'm Carolyn Mottola, and I'm going to read you a story that relates to Christmas. In the spirit of gratefulness and thanksgiving at Christmas time, I would like to tell you about the hymn, It is well with my soul. We all have hymns and songs that are important to us, especially at Christmas time. They bring us joy, hope, and comfort. The men and women who wrote the lyrics in the earliest years used passages and stories from the Bible. Many of the words of our more recent hymns have come from the personal experiences of the author of the lyrics. The lyrics of one of the hymns that we sing today come from one of the most heart-wrenching stories in the history of hymnology. The author, Horatio Spafford, born 1828 and died 1888, was an elder in a church in Chicago. He had established a very successful law practice and had purchased many properties along the shoreline of Lake Michigan. Horatio and his wife Anna were devout Catholic Christians. Among their close friends were the famous D.L. Moody and his songwriters Ira Sankey and the young Philip Bliss. Spafford's fortune was wiped away after the Great Chicago Fire in 1871. He lost almost everything. He and his wife were already grieving the sudden death of their four-year-old son at the time of the economic downturn. How could things get any worse? Desiring a rest for his wife and four daughters, Spafford planned a European trip for his family in 1873. In November of that year, due to unexpected business matters, Horatio had to remain in Chicago, but sent his wife and daughters on ahead as scheduled on the SS Ville du Havre. He expected to follow in a few days. On November 22nd, the ship was struck by the Lockhart, an English vessel, and sank in just a few minutes. Over 200 passengers died that day, including the Spafford girls, Anna, age 11, Margaret Lee, age 9, Elizabeth, age 5 1/2, and 2-year-old Tanetta. Several days later, the few surviving passengers and crew finally landed at Cardiff, Wales, and Anna Spafford cabled her husband, "Saved alone." Spafford left immediately to join his wife. As his vessel approached the area of the ocean, thought to be where the ship carrying his daughters had died, Horatio was overcome with grief. According to Bertha Spafford Vester, a daughter born after the tragedy, he wrote, it is well with my soul on this sad journey." Anna and Horatio, saddened beyond measure, returned to Chicago and spent most of their time helping those who were left with nothing. In early 1875, Philip Bliss, who by this time was a well-known hymn composer, was given the words that Spafford had penned. He knew of the tragedy of his friend's family and was very moved by Horatio's words of faith and peace. It is said that Bliss wrote all the music in one sitting. He called the melody Ville du Havre, after the ship that carried the girls to their graves. Bliss was already considered the second most popular hymn writer of all times when he introduced it is well with my soul in 1876. Philip Bliss had a beautiful voice and sang this song just 1 month before he and his wife were killed in a train wreck on their way back to Chicago from their Christmas celebration with their two young children. Philip was just 38 years old. What sorrow surrounds this song? it is well with my soul. The lives of two families changed forever. But together, Philip Bliss and Horatio Spafford composed a wonderful hymn of hope that lives on for us all to sing. We all can identify with grief, helplessness, assurance, forgiveness, love, and peace. The words that frame this song, that Christ died for us all and that he will come again. The beautiful melody can lift our hearts and bring us joy, thanksgiving, and peace. Whatever my lot, though thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Merry Christmas, everyone, and may you be blessed with peace, love, and joy as we celebrate the birth of Christ. Thank you.